Using UDP messaging on a Do-More is easy. You just create a UDP device and then use packet out and packet in instructions to send and receive messages. That's it. For example, suppose we want to send a short 15-character ASCII message from a PC to the Do-More via UDP. Let's say the message looks like this. Each 3-character set would be a parameter of some kind that the Do-More needs to respond to. The underscores aren't used, they were just added to make the data easier to see when we look at the message in the data view. To read that into the Do-More via UDP, we just create a UDP device. Click on the Configure button, and then click on Device Configuration. Click on New Device, and create a UDP connection. Give it a name, we'll call ours UDP Demo, and let's listen on port 60001. Now, the only port that the Do-More uses is this 28784, so you can use anything else from 1 to 65535, just make sure it's compatible with your network. Now, be careful, most lower numbered UDP ports have predefined uses, so I usually avoid lower number ports. When you write this project to the Do-More, this device will listen to the Ethernet port and capture any message sent via UDP to the port you put here. All you have to do is wait for the device to say it has a new message and then get it from the device. Since we just created a device, Do-More Designer automatically creates a structure for that device. Let's open a data view and take a look at it. Device structures begin with a dollar sign, and the name of our device was UDP Demo. When I hit the dot, I see this device has 3 structure members available. One tells me packets have been captured and are ready for me to use. One tells me how many packets are available, and one tells me that a packet was sent. Let's use the packet available member as a contact to tell us when the Do-More has received a UDP message to that 60001 port. When this contact tells us that the device has received a packet, we just use a packet in instruction to read the message from the UDP device. Here's the UDP device that we created. Now, when a packet's received, it has the sender's IP address and UDP port in the message. Those will get put in whatever variables we put here. You can then use those in your ladder code to filter out the messages. Maybe you need to respond from messages from one IP address differently than messages from another IP address. Or maybe you need to respond differently from messages from one port versus another port. Something like that. Here you can specify a timeout. Now you may ask, what do I need a timeout for if I'm just reading data from a buffer? Especially since the packet available structure member just told me it's ready to go. Well, you really don't. For us, in this little example here, and probably most of your projects too, it's not a big deal. Just take the default. However, if you are interested in how it might be used, then check out the Do-More help file. This is actually a really powerful feature for large complex projects. Let's change the number of bytes to read to 64, so we can use a string short right here as the place we want the message to end up. Keep in mind, we could have created a special string size just for this message. The Do-More allows you to create any string size you want, but we're going to be lazy here and just use the built-in string short. Well, that's it. Step 1, create a device and configure, and step 2, use a packet in to read the data when the device says it has a message for us. Easy. Let's add the string short 0, D0, and V0 to the data view so we can see what happens when a message is received. Let's accept the changes, save the project, and write it out to the Do-More. Now, if I send my 15-byte message from the PC to the Do-More, the UDP device we created collects the message for us. It sets a flag telling us the message is available, and we read the message from the device into SS0. We also see that D0 and V0 get populated with the sender's IP address and UDP port. Perfect. Now, what if in addition to receiving messages from the PC, you also want to send a message to the PC from the Do-More? Easy. You just use a packet out instruction. It needs the exact same information, a device that's handling the messaging for you, the IP address and port number you want to send a message to, and the data you want to send. Done. What if you send a message from the PC and a Do-More doesn't get it? What do you do now? Well, I like to use a free open source program called Wireshark. This guy shows you every packet being sent across your network. That's usually a lot of data to sift through, so you'll want to add a filter. To filter on the Do-More's IP address, I simply type ip.addr double equals in the Do-More's IP address. Now I only see messages to or from the Do-More. I'll send a message from the PC, and sure enough, I see that a message was sent from my PC's IP address to the Do-More's IP address via UDP using these ports. And down here, you can even see that 15 characters were sent and what they are in hex. So at a glance, you can now tell that the message actually left this IP address, it went to this IP address, and which UDP ports were used in the message. Usually, if a message isn't received, the destination IP address or the UDP port number don't match what the Do-More is expecting. You just need to make sure the Do-More project matches these numbers. As a reminder, the Do-More's IP address is here under the Info button, and UDP port is here under the Configure button. Please keep in mind that Wireshark is not an AutomationDirect product, so please don't call support asking for help with that. There are lots of excellent videos on YouTube and the Wireshark website at www.wireshark.org. Of course, if you have any questions about AutomationDirect's products, please don't hesitate to contact AutomationDirect's award-winning, free tech support during regular business hours. Spend less, do more at AutomationDirect.com.